Hello everyone and welcome to my, one of the last episodes of my Baggage of Control gameplay. It's the second to last actually. So yeah, we're going to do the open class challenges. So first of all I have to fully upgrade the Bahawak, because I do not want to do, each race a lot. So yeah, each vehicle is going to be fully upgraded, at least when it comes to the engine. And yeah, this one has the full power, so I'm going to get to the race as soon as the menus allow me to do so. So yeah, first of all, it's going to be the Kicker Open Class Challenge at the Tampico Beach circuit. So yeah, fairly easy race. I did it on the first try. That was, that was very pleasing for me. So there I am. This first jam is very critical, and it's also very annoying because, yeah, you start in a very bad position. Like, you start way the fuck ahead, but yeah, that position is so bad. So yeah, this was fairly easy. I mean, it's the first one. Like, yeah, difficulty kind actually increases as you go on. And I don't know if it's because of the, of how spaced out cars are, or maybe it's because, how good or bad you are. So yeah, I didn't have that much of a problem winning here. Again, I guess the extra power was perfect for this track, because yeah, this track doesn't have like, many actual difficulties. I mean, we've already done it. I mean, it gave me like a lot of problems in the class 1 buggy, but yeah, outside of that, yeah, I mean, it's absolutely easy. I think I preloaded that jump to make it sure I was going to clear it. And you can see that the Scott is actually, closing in on me. But yeah, I mean, he's nowhere near close. Like, yeah, we've been like around between 8 and 7 seconds for a while. And then I think he made a mistake or something. So yeah, he lost even more time. So yeah, very easy win. 55 for the second lap, which is the only valid lap. The game doesn't recognize the first lap as a quick one in the records. It does here, but yeah, who cares? And Derek Douglas with an unlimited BW finished, fairly down the list. I think it was, 4x4, the one that finished second. So yeah, I unlocked the Moss Racing Class 1600, 5 limited and another 1600. And I somehow earned the sponsorship. So yeah, there was absolutely that. I feel like I do not have all the invitationals unlocked because of a combination of, of having the right sponsor or something like that, I don't know. So yeah, next up, unlimited BW class, which is, real life class 5, fully upgraded. So yeah, pretty much the same, just doing it. I mean, it's fairly annoying because, I have to do it for every single car, but yeah. And yeah, I mean, I do not remember the, which race, which class I use for each racetrack, but yeah. Next time it's the Oakley Open Class Challenge at the Laughlin Desert racetrack at Nevada. I think this was, I think this was another first try. I just had a very good race, to be honest. I mean, for the very first, for the moment I started the race, I just started, like decimating all the difference from the Bahawak. For example, at first I was a bit worried, like, yeah, it didn't look like I was gaining much on him, but it was, it was more about like, yeah, where I was positioned and where he was positioned. Also, Bradley Baldwin for a moment there got very close to me. But after that, I mean, I just powered through and, yeah, everything worked out and, I don't know, it was fairly easy. Yeah, I mean, still, lowest classes. I mean, you can see that, well, Edgar still has quite some difference. But the laps here are fairly long. And I knew how to do it. So, yeah. For example, here I went out of it, a bit too slow. I had a bit of a problem there. Bradley Wallman choosing the inside line, I think that didn't work out for him. And yeah, having to use the gearbox a lot because yeah, this is a 5-speed. And yeah, it makes me use all the speeds. And yeah, I had a big problem here. I just went out of control. I was panicking here. I was like, oh my god, I'm losing this. But no, 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 everything went fine. And yeah, I managed to correct it and just go for Edgar Alvarez Jr., the Baja Bag representative of this race. By the way, a class 1600 I had just unlocked. Yeah, I unlocked it with the Tampico Beach race. So yeah, I just went to the inside, and yeah, did it cleanly, fairly easy. Like, you know, I know the car is fully upgraded, and I know I'm pushing like fucking hell, but yeah, this was all fairly easy. And for example, right now in third place there is the Open Wheel representative. It's Maria Martensen. I don't remember the, you know, I think it's Martensen Racing or something like that. But yeah, she went to third. And I think she managed to pass Edgar in the end. Not entirely sure though. Like, yeah, I mean, this was fairly easy for me. Again, I mean, the power is important and I know how to drive. At least on this game, like, here I'm fairly, I mean, I'm not perfect or anything like that, but yeah, I'm good enough, I think. Like, I can recognize the bumps, I can react to them and all that. Like, for example, here I tried it was a fairly awkward line, but it allowed me to not slow down. And that is quite important, because yeah, if you're slowing down, for example, yeah, Edgar had to slow down, he lost like maybe 5 seconds there. Just because he had to slow down, and then, you know, he doesn't have as much power. Here, yeah, I mean, different line, but this wasn't good either. Yeah, I had a couple of shitty lines around that place. So yeah, final part of the track, Maria Martensen getting very close to Edgar Alvarez Jr. I think she passed him. I mean, I don't know exactly, but I think she did. So yeah, here much better than before, although I was still very sketchy. And at least I didn't went off the track and, you know, close to the pickup trucks there. And yeah, Edgar is holding his ground for now. So yeah, another race win, 2 out of 2. So yeah, Edgar finished, he finished second. Maria didn't manage to do it. Vanderway went with the full size track on 4th, Ballman on 5th with the 4x4, Randy Perry with the class 1 buggy 1st, and Bradley Looney with the shorter, with the mini track 7th, and trophy track 8th. So yeah, I unlocked the Pollution Racing Unlimited without you, and that was all. I thought there would be more. Checking the, you know, the invitationals, but yeah, I cannot do them. I don't think I did. I didn't do any invitational on this part. Like, yeah. So yeah, now with the 4x4 class, I think I kept this car fully stock except for, you know, the reliability upgrades. I think I kept it. Full stock. So yeah, just spending money, a lot of that. I mean, yeah, for the whole video, the money is always around 2.4 million, but yeah, bit up, a bit down. Then, you know, progressive open class challenge and it's not the inversing challenge. It's I think the name here is Playa Grande. I was freaking out because I thought it was going to be inversing summit. And I was like, holy fuck, that's gonna be a long race and a tough one. But no, it wasn't. I mean, this is not Inversing Summit or anything like that. I think this is Playa Grande. So yeah. Playa Grande, which is, you know, fairly demanding track when it comes to the engine, because yeah, very long straights. But yeah, for example, you know, with the upgrades, I can hit 100 miles an hour fairly easily. Jumping with Steve Griffith side by side, and then on to, you know, to try to get Ron Thomas. And yeah, Ron Thomas had a very bad run, I guess, and yeah, I passed him after only 40 seconds. Then he tried to fight me. But yeah, I mean, I had, you know, I had the power on my side. So yeah, there was, you know, no way for him. I mean, I can still hear him and all that, but yeah, I mean, he has no actual options, like, yeah. Unless I would, you know, I made a big, big mistake. So yeah, Ron Thomas and Stevie Griffith, or, you know, still second and third. Ron Thomas, Ron Thomas is still second. So yeah, this was still the first attempt, like, you know, these were on a clean run. I was very happy for that. Because I was like, yeah, clean runs, like, you know, not having to restart or anything like that. You know, that was nice. And yeah, Ron Thomas held on for second for the whole fucking lap, which is fucking awful because, you know, everyone was faster than him. And Jim Hinsley went with the mini track on third, and Wing Lang with the full size track on fourth, and Mark Milling fifth with a class one buggy. Open Wheel was the worst, and well, Unlimited BW at the very end, I think he flipped or something like that, because yeah, that's the only way, like, he could have dropped so much positions at that time. Oh yeah, I unlocked the Millenworks Toyota FJ Cruiser and the Westview Racing Jeep Wrangler. Still, you know, invitational, but yeah, I cannot do them. So going for the next class, which is the Open Wheels, so yeah, time for my Kenworth Millennium buggy. And it looks so odd, but I like it. I like it a lot, actually. I think it's a... At first I thought it was some kind of fantasy track. Fantasy buggy. Because I was like, yeah, there's no way somebody's driving, you know, buggy with that kind of side pods and the wing and all that. I was like, yeah, there's no way. But actually there is. And it's a fucking, and it's fucking awesome that it exists. And yeah, it's even more awesome than it exists, you know, on the, even on the, you know, class one buggy, you know, version. So yeah, Painless Open Challenge at Dead Bank Wash at the Unisal Flats. I think this was the first attempt, I'm not entirely sure. I think it was. And I'm not entirely sure, but I think it was, yeah, because I was fairly lucky. Yeah, I remember, yeah, I was fairly lucky. Because the Baja Bug guy started like shit, and then, you know, everything was, you know, fairly tight up front, you know, fairly easy to go you know, to the right place, to go to first place. So yeah, just driving. This time I have to do quite some driving before I get them. But yeah, once I get them, like, I pass them all like in, I don't know, like 5 seconds or so. And it was fairly weird for me. Like, I wasn't expecting this. I don't know if I preloaded that. Maybe I did it on the second lap. I think I did it on the second lap. So yeah, I think it's on the SS. Like, yeah, Melwaite goes wide. Then Kevin Carr is showing, like, you know, not much speed. And he slided out. So I was like, okay, let's try to get a good line around him. And I did it. And then it was time for Ernesto Aguilar. And yeah, I don't think Ernesto Aguilar lasted much for me. Like, I think it was maybe right after the hairpin or something like that. Yeah, I mean, yeah, he made a mistake there, and yeah, that was the whole story. You know, 17 seconds into the second lap, and that was it. I mean, it's fine, but yeah, like, I was expecting a bit more battle. I mean, it still was the hardest one, because yeah, I had to go to for the second lap to pass everybody. But yeah, it was fairly easy. This track is quite a mess, you know, lots of bumps. I guess it doesn't favor like top speed, but the power is definitely needed. For example, we can see that Kevin Carr has run away from everyone, while Ernesto Aguilar is blocking the road, I guess. Oh yeah, no, here I didn't preload, but I tried a different line and it worked wonders. Like, you know, a lot more speed carried down here. That was a fairly nice discovery for me. And yeah, for Jim Hinsley, he's on third with a mini track. Minitrax starts right after me, so yeah, third place is alright, even though, you know, he's very much, you know, way too far ahead. And then, you know, Kevin Carr had problems again with the SS. He had problems on both times. That's pretty bad. So yeah, and Roger Norman, you know, finally a trophy track, not on 8th. Like, you know, he finished 5th. Full size track on 7th, and the young class 1 buggy on 8th. So I'm just trying, you know, just checking out the final results. So yes, almost 2.4 million, and I've unlocked the Kayser Racing buggy, the Off Madison Avenue Racing buggy, and the Nick Baldwin trophy card. Which I think it's a real trophy card, like, you know, not one made by the game. Which, yeah, I think some of them are made by the game, like, you know, on purpose. Like, ex-professor, they say. So, yeah, I knew that, you know, my mini track was already fairly upgraded, so yeah, I didn't even bother upgrading it more. So yeah, this one was the Trail Ready Open Class Challenge at the Goldust circuit at Painted Desert. Or Painted Desert or something. I don't know how to pronounce it for some reason. I had a fairly good start. That's always good, you know. I mean, it's always positive to get a good start, so yeah. Everything is a bit closer to you. I knew that the DSs were going to be key. I didn't know how much. So yeah, I made you know, quite a mistake here. Oh yeah, I restarted this one. Why the fuck did I restart this one? I mean, I slid it out, but it wasn't that bad. Whatever, I'm just gonna keep it on the video, I don't care. So yeah, you know, restarting this one. This was the second attempt. And this was, I think this one came down to the line. Like, actually to the fucking line. Like, very close, very close. I think it was pretty much a photo finish, I think. Well, I don't know, or maybe, yeah, I think it was a photo finish-ish moment with the Baja bug. So yeah, Mike Lopez overtaking Michelle Bragman. I think Michelle Bragman is not, yeah, it's an unlimited BW and an open wheel. So yeah, hitting Mike Lopez. And then, you know, trying to face Michelle, but I cannot do it. Trying to run, her, you know, on the outside. I managed to keep, you know, most of the speed. And maybe it wasn't a photo finish. I don't know, I had a very close finish with a Baja bug. Like, overtaking him, like, on the very last bit. I don't know. And yeah, Gary Messer got, you know, run wide by Mel Waite on the Jeep Wrangler. Jeep Speed Jeep Wrangler. So yeah, I'm just facing Mel Waite with like half a lap to go. This was a fairly stressful race because yeah, the, you know, that 4x4 Jeep was doing fine for most of the race. Then he got fucked for some reason, like, you know, like maybe he ran too hot or something. I don't know, but yeah, he faded out. It was quite a shame, to be honest. So yeah, they did fairly nice, you know, here in the group section, and yeah, minute 0.8. So yeah, maybe I could have won it, like, you know, even with the slide out, but I don't know, I just didn't want to do that. And yeah, full size track finishing 4th, open with 2nd, class 1 buggy 7th, and trophy track 8th. It was Aaron Flueger. So yeah, another race down, like, I think we are already, like, even more than halfway through, and I've unlocked, you know, the Camburg mini track and the Austin Reed Racing trophy card. So yeah, going for the... Austin Reed is, you know, is an actual racer, like, yeah. He's no, you know, he's like 8 years older now, so yeah. He's driving, I think it's oval racing, like dirt tracks or something. So yeah, time for the full-size trophy track. THQ Open Class Challenge at the Grand Bridge Pass track. And yeah, with my already fully upgraded F-150. And I don't know if this one was the first attempt, but yeah, Jim Kingsley fucked the start completely. Like, I'm even looking back like, what the fuck, guy? So yeah, Robert Macbeth or Macbeth is the next one. Grandbridge Pass is, you know, a fairly good track for this kind of racing. And yeah, well, for example, I'm seeing that there are two classes very tight together up front. Okay, and this was a restart, another one. God damn it, me! I ate a rock. I mean, it's fairly understandable, you know. Like, yeah, you would have done the same. Don't judge me. I preloaded this jump. I think it worked a bit well. I mean, not entirely well. And then I beat the crap out of Jim Kingsley to the point I fucking spun him out. Like, yeah, that hit was so vicious, like, he got spun out. There, you know, trying to overtake Macbeth. Again, extremely rough. Not as rough as, you know, as with Jim. But yeah, this turn is fairly hard, you know, because you want to keep the speed, but yeah, you also want, you also want to get to the next turn safe and sound. This part is possibly, you know, one of the most critical, also one of the most critical, you know, on the track. And then, okay, the, you know, Brandon Mask had a problem. Scott Hartman, you know, jumped over me, you know, he went wide and jumped over me. And then it was me against Drew Velk, trying to do it, and I think I got very rough with him. Yeah, I spun him out as well. I spun two cars out in a fucking race. All on the same turn, by the way. So yeah, landing everything very hard, like, yeah, I don't care, it's a very short race, and I was like, I was going crazy for the win. There, I tried a different line. I think it worked out better. And then I tried to do this inside, but I think that was a bit too slow. But yeah, 58.0. That was a decent lap. So yeah, Jesse James finished fourth with the trophy truck. Brandon Moss somehow managed to finish second. And then Mark Caswell with the Class 1 buggy. You know, it's a Baja Challenge car, but yeah, it's, you know, here it's a Class 1 buggy. He finished 7th. I don't know about some of the other guys. So yeah, I unlocked the PacWest F250 and the Pistol Racing Trophy Track, which is a weird moment to start unlocking trophy tracks here, you know, Pistol and Herman Motorsports. Again, checking out the invitationals, but nothing. So yeah, time for the Class 1 buggy. And this one needed a few tries, if I remember well. I don't know if I kept them on the video, but yeah, I needed a few tries. So yeah, I went like close to 2.5 millions, but yeah, I had to fully upgrade this Class 1 buggy. I think I finished the gameplay with like 2.4 exactly or something like that, like, yeah, around that very number. So yeah, time for the Bully Dog Open Class Challenge at the Dancing Wolf track in Lake Powell. Fairly hard. This was fairly hard. Like, yeah, I mean, not the hardest one. The hardest one was the next one. The next one was fucking hell. But yeah, it was hard. Okay, I didn't get the start there. Had to, you know, re-clutch the engine. So yeah, here it was fairly easy to make mistakes, like, you know, the rocks and all that, and for example me going wide. Yeah, I did a restart. I don't know why I kept, you know, these restarts. Like, yeah, I edited these, you know, the images like a couple of days ago, and I do not know why I did it like that. Like, yeah, it could have been, like, you know, cleaner. I don't know, you can see that, you know, those mistakes, even though they look, you know, small, they can be very important here, trying to keep the speed, avoiding everyone. Because yeah, this was a perfect spot, like, you know, I could take three cars, I almost did. And then I went crazy for the inside, you know, it was basically because I bumped against Macbeth or whoever that was. But that was, you know, that was a very important pass for me. And then, oh yeah, this turn. This turn has a very low burn and then it gets fairly high. The problem is that you must keep the speed, or at least, you know, as much as you can. Because, you know, there's an uphill. I mean, it's fairly short, it's not that steep, but yeah, it's still an uphill and it's still important. I know, here it's, you know, a track, you know, where cutting corners is very important. And then, for example, there, Brett Cherry with unlimited BW, he just flew off the track. And then, for example, overtaking Norberto Rivera, and I think I ran into Melwaite and ran him off the track. And yeah, that was basically it. I mean, yeah, I was a bit of a douche with Melwaite and, you know, with some other drivers. But yeah, I mean, this is an open class challenge. Everything fucking goes. I was going for the win. I mean, I didn't care. To be honest, I stopped caring. Like, from the moment I started with the open class challenges, I was like, yeah, it's not the time to be like clean. It's time to fucking win. How? I don't care. I don't care. It's just about winning. And I did it. 59:38 for the second lap. So yeah, pretty much the same lap as the starting lap. That's how fucking fast I was going. So yeah, it was Macbeth and Herbst with the trophy track finished 6th. And Hinsley with the mini track finished 8th. Yeah, he had a couple of, you know, bad consecutive races, you know, at both. When I was doing the full-sized class and then when I did the Class 1 Unlimited buggies. So I unlocked the Hermann Motorsports Class 1 buggy. And the wide open Baja Challenge car and the Arizona State University Sandoval trophy track, which I guess it's entirely fake because, you know, Arizona State University. I mean, I don't think they have a fucking trophy track. Okay, I did it wrong with the buttons there. And then time to upgrade my goddamn trophy track. Holy fuck, this was so hard. This was around 40 minutes of my life. I'm not kidding. 40 minutes of my life just trying this fucking race. This was so fucking hard. Like, you know, I mean, I was, at first I was like, okay, this is going to be hard because, you know, it's the last one and I'm with the trophy track, which is, you know, it's a bit unfair how far back I was starting. But yeah, this BF Goodrich Open Class Challenge at, you know, at the Apache trail or something like that was fucking hard. Like, for example, here, I did basically two perfect laps and I finished 7 seconds behind the fucking Baja bug. And I was like, how the fuck am I going to improve by 7 seconds? So yeah, I unlocked the Riviera Racing, Kincaid Racing and our Sierra Miller Racing trophy tracks. I check out, you know, the invitationals just in case. And I think I went for a couple more upgrades, although I undid something. I undid this one. Because this one, this suspension upgrade gives the car a lot of ride height. And I didn't like that. Like, you know, the car became very fucking unstable. I even changed the gearing. You know, just to fit with the track. Like, yeah. That was my only objective. I was like, yeah, how the fuck can I go faster here? So I changed the gearing. I made the fourth gear much shorter to, you know, to make it more useful. And then I made, you know, third was, you know, a bit shorter too. And then second was longer. Also, I discovered during these attempts that I could start on third gear. Like, yeah, the track has that much power. I think I was even faster with the goddamn third gear start. I think I'm doing it here. Like, yeah, I can do 0 to 60 like 3 seconds, 3.3 maybe. Like, yeah, that's so fucking unrealistic. So yeah, this is with you know, fully upgraded you know, engine, you know, fully upgraded transmission, fully upgraded tires. You know, it's the best tires the game has to offer. But it, this is with the 2.0 suspension or 2.5 suspension. Why? Because it's slower. It is lower, and that was very useful for me. You know, when it came to the bumps. Like, yeah, I didn't have as much trouble flipping here than I had, you know, when doing it with the, you know, with the normal, well, sorry, with the fully upgraded suspension. That suspension, you know, just has too much ride height, and yeah, it's not good for racing. Like, I could, when I was cornering, I was feeling very unsafe. I think I was even, slower through corners. Like, I cannot, I'm not sure about that, but it felt slower. So yeah, it was, you know, this was so fucking hard for me. Like, this was crazy. I was going mad, and I was getting fairly desperate, because I was like, I cannot do it. I just cannot do it. Like, you know, I did a fucking full lap, and you know, no passes, and then I, you know, managed to pass both you know, mini track and full size track. You know, with Weyrich, with the class 1 buggy still ahead. I was pushing as hard as I could. I was going fucking crazy all over the track. Holy fuck, this tabletop jump gave me so many headaches. Because, you know, I never knew, you know, the exact way to do it. Like, am I supposed to clear it? Am I supposed to come up a bit short so, you know, I get the power to the ground, you know, earlier? I don't know, it was so hard, so fucking hard. I was, you know, I couldn't even imagine. I mean, even this attempt was looking fairly fucking bad. Like, you know, I'm halfway through the, you know, through the last lap, and I'm only fifth. I was like, I don't think I can do it. And then, you know, I was stuck, you know, with the unlimited pedal for a bunch of, for a couple of seconds. I jump over the rocks there. Well, I mean, I don't think I jumped over them. It was like more, I went over them and, you know, didn't touch them. That was the whole thing. So yeah, then, you know, Scott Gailey with the unlimited pedal, sorry, open wheel, and I just cut the fucking turn, and I was like, yes! And yeah, that was, you know, that was a fucking experience. That was a fucking ride. And yeah, I finished, you know, I managed to win this, and managed to clear the fucking thing. This was so fucking hard. I didn't even check, you know, position 7th and 8th. I guess it was, you know, the couple of trucks, the mini and the full size one. But holy fuck, this was horrendously hard. And, oh, sorry, it was less than 2.4 millions. Yeah, less than 2.3 millions. I ended up spending over a million credits on upgrades. And yeah, I earned 1.6 million done as sponsors. And yeah, only 2 out of 3 invitationals done. I know it's a fairly big portion, but it's very hard to unlock the sponsorships.